Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Mashallah, this is the first video of answering allegations, misconceptions and mockery against Islam by some of the non-Muslims, especially Christian missionaries. So inshallah, today we'll be reviewing the video of so-called ex-Muslim Mario Joseph. He claims that he was an imam of a masjid and later he found Christianity. So word by word, we'll be pondering on his video and his testimony. Now when you look up to this photograph of this person, Mario Joseph, it says Mario Joseph as an Islamic imam before his conversion. Can you imagine an imam of any masjid in any part of the world without a beard? Without a beard. Can you imagine an imam of a masjid without a beard? So this person, he claims by showing this photograph that he was an imam. So this is the first lie of this person, Mario Joseph.
At the time of my baptism, my spiritual father asked me what name you prefer. So my name was Sulaiman ibn Ahmad in Islam. So all the fathers said, you keep Solomon. Solomon is Sulaiman. I said, no, I love Mother Mary so much, so I need Mother Mary's name. And then they said, it's a lady's name, you are men. I said, we will find out some name. Then one of the priests who was from Italy, he said, Mario. So that's how I got the name Mario, Italian name, because I love Mother Mary. And then second name they asked what I said, if Mary is there, then let it be Joseph. So Mario Joseph.
So in this part of the clip, he claims that his original name was Suleiman, and one of the priests, and he claims that that priest is a spiritual father, note it down, spiritual father of this person, Mario Joseph. And he loved Mother Mary so much that he kept his name as Mario. Mario, not the video game, but his name, Mario Joseph.
While I was working in a Muslim masjid as an imam, as a parish priest, once I preached in my parish that Jesus Christ is not God. For me, God was only Allah. And I believe Allah never married, so no son for Allah. So I preached there that Jesus is not God. Then somebody asked me, who is Jesus? From the crowd. Maybe a Muslim, but he asked me, who is Jesus? I was preaching, he is not God. But the question, who is he? To know who is he, I read the entire Quran once again. 114 chapters, 6,666 verses in Quran.
Now he said that to know Jesus, he has read the entire Quran. 114 surahs, that is known as chapters, and 6,666 verses of the Quran. So my question is that before knowing Jesus Christ, how did he become imam of a masjid? So this is the clear lie that he was an ex-Muslim. To know about Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, he might have gone to the index of the Quran. In any translation of the copy of the Quran, you may find the index, and under the name J and under the name M, Maryam alayhi salam and Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, he could have read entire thing about Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. He says that to know Jesus, he read 6,666 verses of the Quran from Surah Fatiha to Surah Nas, only to know about Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. This is the clear lie that he's claiming.
When I read it, the name of Prophet Muhammad I found in Quran 4 places, but the name of Jesus I found 25 places. There itself I was little confused. Why Quran giving more preference for Jesus?
Now again, remember, he's an ex-imam. He says that the name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is only 4 times in the Quran, and the name of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, is 25 times in the Quran. He does not know, being an ex-imam, so-called ex-imam, that the name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioned 5 times in the Quran. 4 times as Muhammad and 1 time as Ahmad in Surah Saf, Surah number 61, ayat number 6. Ahmad is also one of the name of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as mentioned in Sahih Bukhari volume number 4, hadith number 732. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, I have got 5 names: Muhammad, Ahmad, Mahi, Hashir and Aqib. These are the 5 names of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Being an ex-Muslim, as he claims, he does not know that the name of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is also Ahmad. And he gives one of the reasons to get confused, that the name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is only four times, as he claims, and the name of Prophet Jesus Christ is mentioned 25 times in the Quran. So the importance of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, is much more than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the glorious Quran. We say that the name of Adam, may peace be upon him, is also 25 times in the Quran. The name of Moses, may peace be upon him, is 136 times in the glorious Quran. The name of Prophet Abraham is mentioned 69 times in the Quran. The name of Prophet Nuh is mentioned 47 times in the glorious Quran. The name of Prophet Lot, Lut alayhi salam, is mentioned 27 times in the glorious Quran. The name of Pharaoh, that is the Pharaoh, his name is mentioned for 74 times in the glorious Quran. So will he accept Pharaoh as the son of God or God himself?
And second thing, I could not see any woman's name in Quran. Prophet Muhammad's mother name or wife's name or children name, no. In the Quran, there is only one woman name I found, Maryam, the mother of Jesus. No other woman name. And in the Holy Quran chapter 3, the name of the chapter is Family of Maryam. And the Holy Quran chapter 19, the name of the chapter itself is Maryam. One chapter is Maryam. So I was very curious to know why this Quran says all these things.
Now, one more error, one more mistake done by this so-called Imam. He said that the name of the chapter number 3 of the glorious Quran is Family of Maryam. It's not Family of Maryam, it's Family of Imran, Ale Imran. It is not Ale Maryam, it is Family of Imran. One more point to note, that this person is not the ex-imam. He made a mistake and he says that the name of chapter number 3 of the glorious Quran is Family of Maryam alayhi salam. And he says that the name of the mother of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not mentioned in the Quran. Neither the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam are mentioned in the Quran. Neither any of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam are mentioned in the glorious Quran. So he was very much confused to know that why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention the name of mother of Jesus, and why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave one whole chapter in the name of the mother of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. That is Surah Maryam, Surah number 19 of the glorious Quran. The simple answer is that the glorious Quran was sent as a guidance for the mankind. If you read the glorious Quran in Surah Baqara, Surah number 2, ayat number 185, God Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that this Quran was sent as a guidance for the whole of the mankind. This Quran does not contain the genealogy of any of the prophets. This Quran does not contain the names of the mother of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This Quran does not mention about the names of the companions of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The whole idea of mentioning of the name of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, and his mother, is that the Christians, they used to believe that Jesus is God, the Son of God. And many of the Christians, they used to believe that Maryam alayhi salam is also God. So to eradicate this concept of Jesus being the Son of God and Mother Mary being God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the verses in the glorious Quran in the name of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, and his mother Mary. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was directly communicating to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was informing about Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, and Mother Mary. So in the direct communication, you need not take the name of the person to whom you are talking to. You will take the name of the person who is not present. In the same way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was speaking to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was talking about Maryam alayhi salam and Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him.
About Maryam, Holy Quran chapter 3 verses 34 onwards says that Mary was born without original sin. She never committed any sin in her life. She was ever virgin. Quran chapter 50 verses 23 says that she went to heaven with her physical body. Even the assumption is written in Holy Quran.
Again a clear-cut lie by this person. He said that in Surah Al Imran, Surah number 3, ayat number 34, it says that Maryam alayhi salam was born without an original sin. The ayah of Surah Al Imran, Surah number 3, ayat number 34 does not say so. And he said again in Surah Qaf, Surah number 50, ayat number 23, he said that Quran mentions that Maryam alayhi salam was taken up alive with the physical body. If you read the Quran in Surah Qaf, Surah number 50, ayat number 23, it does not say so. Again, the clear cut lie, the white lie uttered by this person.
And then about Jesus, when I read chapter 3 verses 45 to 55 verses, there are 10 points which Quran makes about Jesus. The first thing Quran says, Kalimatullah, the Arabic word which means word of God. And the second thing, Ruhullah, which means spirit of God. And the third is Isa al-Masih, which means Jesus Christ. So Quran gives the name for Jesus, word of God, spirit of God, Jesus Christ.
Again, the white lie by this person. He said that in Surah Al-Imran, Surah number 3, ayat number 45 to 55, Quran mentions that Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, is Ruhullah, Kalimatullah, and Isa al-Masih, which means, according to him, he says, the word of God, the spirit of God, and Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. If you read the glorious Quran in Surah Al-Imran, Surah number 3, ayat number 45, in this verse, in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, is a word from Allah. He is not the word of Allah. If you read the correct translation of the glorious Quran of Surah Al-Imran, Surah number 3, ayat number 45, it says, when the angel said, O Mary, indeed, Allah gives you a good tidings of a word from him, not of him, whose name will be Messiah, Jesus, the son of Mary. Jesus Christ and a word from him. But this person translated it as word of him. Furthermore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Nisa, Surah number 4, ayat number 171, it says, O followers of the book, Ya Ahlul Kitab, La taghlu fi dinikum, do not exceed in the limits in your religion, and do not speak anything lies against Allah, but speak the truth. The Messiah, Isa, the son of Mary, is only the messenger of Allah, and his word, which he communicated to Maryam, and a spirit from him, not spirit of him. This person deliberately mistranslating the ayahs of the glorious Quran, and he claims that he was an ex-Muslim, ex-Imam.
And then Quran says that Jesus spoke when he was very small, like 2 days old after his birth. He began to speak. Quran says that Jesus created a live bird with mud. He took some mud, formed a bird, when he breathed into it, it became a live bird. So I think that he can give life. He gave life to a mud, clay. And then Quran says that Jesus cured a man born blind and a man with leukoderma, leprosy, etc. Continuously, Quran says that Jesus gave life to dead people. Jesus went to heaven, he is still alive, and he will come again.
So basically, in this part of the video, this person, he claims that Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, is God because he performed miracles. He gave some of the examples. Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, he healed lepers. Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, he gave life to a bird. Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, gave life to a dead person. And as a Muslim, we too believe that Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, he performed miracles. So one of the reasons of accepting Christianity this person gives is that Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, performed miracles. He gave life to a dead person. He gave life to a mud and it became a bird. He gives the reason. And he claimed that he read the Quran from chapter 1, Surah 1 to Surah number 114, that is Surah Nas. But unfortunately, he forgot to read a verse of the Bible. If you read Book of Acts, chapter number 2, verse number 22, it says, Hear, men of Israel, Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested by God, did wonders and miracles which God did through him. What does the Bible say? The miracles which was done by Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, was actually done by God Almighty. The clear verse of the Bible, if you go and read the Bible, any version of the Bible, Book of Acts, chapter number 2, verse number 22. It says, Hear, men of Israel, Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested by God, did wonders and miracles which God did through him. This is the testimony of the Bible. If you read Gospel, in the Gospel of John, chapter number 5, verse number 30, it says, I can of my own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, because I seek not my own will, but the will of the Father who has sent me. The clear testimony of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. Jesus says, I can of mine own self do nothing. Now, this person, he claims that he accepted Christianity and he accepted Bible and he accepted Jesus. Why? Because Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, he performed miracles. And who can perform miracles? Who can give life to dead? God. So Jesus did so, and Jesus is God. This is his theory.
When I saw all these things in Quran, my thinking was what the Quran says about Muhammad. You know, according to Quran, Prophet Muhammad is not the word of God, not the spirit of God, never spoke when he was 2 days old, never created any bird with mouth, never cured any sick people, never raised any dead people. He himself died. And according to Islam, he is not alive and he will not come back. So there is a lot of difference between these two prophets. I don't call Jesus as God, you know. My idea was he's a prophet, but he's a prophet greater than Muhammad.
Now, one of the idea he gives that he accepted Jesus and the Christianity is because Jesus spoke in his cradle. Yes, we Muslims do accept that Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, he spoke in the cradle. But he was not the only person who spoke in the cradle. In the history, if you read, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said there were three infants who spoke in the cradle. The very first one was Juraij, and second is Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. And the third person, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam narrated an incident where an infant, he rejected the supplications of his mother. So there were three persons in the history who spoke in their cradle. Jesus was not only person who spoke in the cradle. So this person, he thought that Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, is the only person who spoke in the cradle. So he's greater than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he's greater than everybody. And he compared between the prophets, between Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As a Muslim, if you read Surah Baqarah, Surah number 2, Ayat number 285, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لا نفرق بين أحد من رسولي. That as a Muslim, we do not differentiate between the prophets. From Prophet Adam, may peace be upon him, till Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we do not differentiate. But this person, he has compared Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he said that Jesus is alive and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he died. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has a lesser degree than Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. As a Muslim, I do not compare between the prophets. The miracles of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of the miracle of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with the indication of the finger, the moon was split into two. This was one of the miracle of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One of the miracles of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the glorious Quran. Being an illiterate, being an ummi, he received the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whole of the mankind, and it is still preserved. This is one of the miracle of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But the Injil of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, was never written, neither it was saved by his companions. So as a Muslim, I am not comparing between Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But a testimony of a non-Muslim by the name Michael H. Hart, in his book The 100, he gave number one position to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and number three position to Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. And he gives the reason, being a non-Muslim, he gives the reason why he has put Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on number one position. The reason he gave is, he said, my choice of Muhammad to lead the list of the world's most influential persons may surprise some readers and may be questioned by others, but he was the only man in history who was supremely successful on both the religious and secular level. This is the testimony of a non-Muslim towards Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
And you know, at the end, what I did, I took my Quran, kept on my chest, and I said, Allah, tell me, what should I do? Because your Quran says Jesus is still alive, Muhammad is no more. You tell me, whom should I accept? After my prayer, I opened Quran. I didn't ask anyone, I asked only to my Allah. When I opened Quran, I saw chapter 10, verse 94. You know what Quran says? If you have any doubt in this Quran which I give to you, go and read the Bible or ask the people, those who read the Bible. The truth is already revealed in that.
A white lie by this person. He said that the Quran says to read the Bible. He did not read the translation of that verse. The translation of the verse of Surah Yunus, Surah number 10, ayat number 24, it says, so if you are in doubt, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about that which we revealed to you, then ask those who have been reading the scriptures before you. What are the scriptures before you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Torah and Injil. These were the scriptures before the Quran, not the Bible. This person translated it as Bible. The Bible, it means the collection of books. This book, Bible, was not revealed to Prophet Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. Injil was revealed to Prophet Jesus, may peace be upon him. And if you read today's Bible, you will not find Injil of Jesus. You may find Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Peter, Paul, Romans, Galatians, Revelation, and all those chapters in the Bible. But you will not find Injil of Jesus, Gospel of Jesus. So this person is deliberately mistranslating the ayahs of the glorious Quran and claiming to be an ex-Muslim. By this white lies of this person, we may come to know that people like this, they are hidden Christians and they claim to the world they were ex-Muslims, and now by reading the ayahs of the Quran and reading the verses of the Bible, they have converted into Christianity. So these are the tricks, new tricks of the Christian missionaries to bluff people.
And then while I was doing my Bible studies, there are a lot of points which touched me from Bible. The first day, Father read John chapter 1 verse 1 onwards. In the beginning there was a word, the word was with God, the word was God, the word became flesh. So my Holy Quran says Jesus is the Word of God. Now the Holy Bible also says Jesus is the Word of God. So I found it both is very similar. And I was happy to know that I need Quran and I need Bible both. You know, I was in a mood like one day become Christian, one day Muslim, one day Christian, you know, I need both.
So he is making a mockery of him. He says one day he wants to be Christian, one day he wants to be a Muslim. Again he mistranslated the ayat of the Quran of Surah Al Imran, Surah number 3, ayat number 45. Allah says that Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, is a word from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the common verse to prove the divinity of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, if you read Gospel of John chapter number 1, verse number 1, it says, in the beginning was the word was with God, and the word was God. If you replace the word with the word God, it is like, in the beginning was the God, the God was with God, and the God was God. Does it give any sense to you? If you read the original manuscripts of this verse, it says, in the beginning was the word was with God. The word God here in the original manuscripts is tontios, and the word was with God. This word, the second word, God, is hotios, meaning a false God. So you yourself making a mockery, and you say that you believe in Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, as God. If you translate it in English, the original manuscripts, it says, in the beginning was the word was with God, the original God, and the word was God, the false God, the original God with a capital G, and a false God with a small g, and the word was God. A word was God means a word was a false God. So you yourself making a mockery of yourself, and you claim to believe in Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him.
While I was thinking like that, again one more word I heard, that was John chapter 1 verse 12. Such a lovely word for me, because it's written in Bible, if anyone accept Jesus, Jesus will give them power to become children of God. In all the verses of the Quran, Allah calls the human being slaves, and Allah is master. Master cannot love the slave, slave cannot love the master. I don't like to be called by someone a slave. Quran says, you are my slave. But when I heard John chapter 1 verse 12, it says, if you believe in Jesus, Jesus will give you power to become children of God. So immediately I said, I need Jesus because I want to be a child of God. There I began to call my God Daddy. Till then I never knew that I can call God Daddy.
Imagine he's calling God Almighty as Daddy. What would he call his father, his biological father? Uncle? What a joke. He's calling God Almighty as Daddy. And he does not have a grandfather. Why? Because God does not have a father again. So in this verse, again he says that in the Quran, God says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred his believers as slaves. And his Gospel of John, Jesus Christ may peace be upon him, says, if you believe in him, he will make them as the children of God. But he does not know that Jesus Christ may peace be upon him, he himself is a servant of God. In many places of the Bible, Jesus Christ may peace be upon him, he says, he is the servant of God. For example, if you read Gospel of Luke, chapter number 6, verse number 12, it says, he continued all night in prayer to God as a servant. In Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 26, verse number 39, he says, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed, my Father, who, Jesus Christ may peace be upon him, fell on the face and prayed to God as a slave and a servant. Furthermore, in Book of Acts, chapter number 3, verse number 13, it says, the God of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus. In the Bible, Jesus is called as a servant. In the Book of Acts, chapter number 3, verse number 26, it says, God raised up his servant Jesus. In Book of Acts, chapter number 4, verse number 27, it says, your holy servant Jesus, whom you anointed. The servant Jesus. Again, in the Book of Acts, chapter number 4, verse number 30, it says, of your holy servant Jesus. Again, in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 18, it says, behold my servant whom I have chosen, in whom my soul is well pleased. The Bible, it says that Jesus is servant, not God. But this person, he says that Quran refers human beings as slaves. This is the reason he left Islam and he accepted Christianity, because Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, will make him as a children of God. But Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, he himself is a servant according to the Bible.
If you believe in Muhammad and die, you know what will be your situation? Prophet Muhammad died, people buried, and afterwards we don't know where he went. If I believe in him and die, I don't know where I will go. Gautam Buddha, Mahavira, Guru Nanaka, Shirdi, Babi, Kali, Muruga, Basvana, Vamana, so many gods and goddesses in my country, in India. All have lived, created history, they died, people buried, and we don't know where they went. So if I believe in all these gods and goddesses, I don't know what's my future. But Christ, who died, but he came back. So I have a hope, if I die in Christ, I too can come back. So it is better be sure of death, and that should be in Christ.
His claim in this portion of the video, he says that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he died and Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, is alive, he's coming back. So Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, will save him, not Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why? Because he died and we don't know where he has gone. But we say that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam have left behind the Quran, the word of God Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his practical teachings as hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now going to Christianity, what did Jesus leave for his disciples, for his followers? Gospel of Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Peter, Paul, Revelations, Galatians, Corinthians, all these things, all these chapters, all these verses, are they the word of God? Are they the Injil of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him? Are they the teachings of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him? Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, he did not left behind anything for the followers to follow and get the eternal life. But still, this person, he claims that Jesus will give him the eternal life. And he says, when Jesus will come back, Jesus will save him. Again, he forgot to read the verse of the Bible. If you read Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 7, verse number 21. It says, not everyone who calls me Lord, Lord will enter the kingdom of heaven. Not everyone who calls me Lord, Lord will enter the kingdom of heaven. But he who believes in my Father, but he who follows the commandments of God Almighty will enter the kingdom of heaven. And what are the commandments of God? The very first commandment of God in the Old Testament as well as in the New Testament is to believe in only one God. God the Father who is in heaven. God of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Jesus, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and every living being on the face of the earth. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam left behind one of the greatest miracle, one of the greatest guidance for the mankind, that is the glorious Quran and his teachings in the form of ahadith.
Every religion says the block between God and man is sin. And in Islam, for the sin they are offering animal. For their sin they are sacrificing animal. In Hinduism, next birth, next birth. But only in Christianity, Jesus himself took my sin and my punishment, and he removed this sin from me, and he made me pure, and he can surrender me to God, the Father, saying that he is pure and I have purified. I have taken out all his transgression, his punishment and his sins. So now you can take him to heaven.
Now again, the same concept of salvation of Christians. They say that Christ died for my sins. And in this portion of video, he says that Muslims, they sacrifice animals to forgive the sins. Being an ex-imam, as he claims, he does not know that Muslims ask forgiveness for the sins. Not that we sacrifice animals for our sins. We ask forgiveness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins. Now the same concept of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, he died for your sins on the cross to take away the sins of the humanity. He says, Christ died for my sins. And Jesus took my sins. Again, he forgot to read the Bible. If he reads the Bible in the book of Ezekiel, chapter number 18, verse number 20, it says, the soul that sinned, it shall die. The father shall not bear the iniquity of the son, neither shall the son bear the iniquity of the father. The righteousness of the righteousness shall be upon him. The wickedness of the wickedness shall be upon him. If the wicked turns away from his wickedness, he shall not die, he shall live. According to this phrase, according to this verse of the Bible clearly says that no one can take others' sin. Neither you can take my sin, nor I can take your sin. Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, cannot take the sins of the humanity, nor the humanity can take the sins of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. This is the very clear statement in the Bible that no one can take others' sin. This person claiming to be an ex-Christian, and he said that he read the Bible and he read the Quran from very first chapter to the last chapter, but he forgot to read the Bible. In the book of Acts, chapter number 2, verse number 22, it says that Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, performed miracles with the help of God. In the book of Ezekiel, chapter number 18, verse number 20, it says that no one can take other sin. This is very clear in the Bible.
From where I can get eternal life? Only from God. And that is given by Jesus on the cross. So when I partake in his body and in his blood, I am partaking in his life. I am becoming part of his life. So then that's why Jesus calls me brother. And Jesus and me both calls God daddy.
Look how he is making mockery of himself. He is calling himself as the brother of Jesus, and he is claiming that Jesus and this person, Mario, both will call God as daddy. So we'll ask them, where is your mommy? So this is the mockery they are making against the prophets of God. They are making mockery of themselves. They are making mockery of God Almighty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he says that Jesus will give him eternal life. He forgot to read the Bible. If he reads Gospel of John, chapter number 17, verse number 3, it says, Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, he says, this is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true God, and whom Jesus Christ, whom you have sent, Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, in the Bible, he clearly says, the only true God is Father in heaven. And he, meaning Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, is sent by that only true God. This is the clear statement of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, in the Bible.
So if you ask me, who made me Christian? It's not any fathers, it's not any sisters, it's not any bishops, it's not any cardinal, it's not even Pope. But the Holy Quran converted me to Christianity.
Now this person says that if you ask me, who converted me to Christianity? I will answer, Holy Quran converted me to Christianity. We will never ask you who converted you into Christianity, but we will surely ask you who made you to act like this as an ex-Muslim and as an ex-Imam. How much money did you get to act like this? How much money did you get to claim to the people that you were a Muslim and you converted into Christianity by reading the Quran? Did Quran teach you that Jesus is God Almighty? Quran clearly says in Surah Maidah, Surah Nafa, ayat number 72, that Jesus is not God. Quran clearly says in Surah Nisa, Surah number 4, ayat number 157, that Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, is not crucified. Quran clearly says in Surah Maryam, Surah number 19, ayat number 88, that Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, is not the Son of God. Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, is not God. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not beget a son. Quran clearly says in Surah Nisa, Surah number 4, ayat number 171, do not claim Trinity. Do not believe in the concept of Trinity, the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, because God is only one. Now, will you still claim that Quran taught you to convert into Christianity? You are lying, you are bluffing people, you are deceiving people in the name of religion. You were a Christian and you bluffed people and you deceived people and you lied people that you were a Muslim and you converted into Christianity. Don't bluff people, don't deceive people in the name of the religion. You were a Christian, you were a born Christian, you got money and you acted as you were a Muslim and you converted into Christianity. Come out from all this deception. I request all the Christian missionaries not to act against the Bible, not to act against the teachings of the Bible, not to act against the teachings of Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, as mentioned in the Bible. Inshallah, I'll be exposing more so-called ex-Muslims, and inshallah, I'll be answering many allegations, misconceptions, and mockery that is made by all these Christian missionaries and evangelists, inshallah. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.